ஹலோ ஆல், வெல்கம் டு த சேனல் லேர்ன் எவ்ரி திங் கற்க கசடர. ப்ராப்பர் நாலேஜ் ஆஃப் டூல்ஸ் இஸ் வெரி வெரி எசென்ஷியல் ஃபார் அ ஸ்கில்டு கார்பெண்டர். அண்ட் இன் திஸ் வீடியோ வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு ஃபோக்கஸ் ஆன் த காமன்லி யூஸ்டு டூல்ஸ் இன் கார்பெண்டரி ஷாப். ஸோ பிஃபோர் சீயிங் த டூல்ஸ் வி ஹாவ் டு ஃபாலோ சம் ஆஃப் த ரூல்ஸ் அண்ட் ரெகுலேஷன்ஸ் இன் சைட் கார்பெண்டரி ஷாப் ஆர் எனி மெஷின் ஷாப். வி ஹாவ் டு ஃபாலோ சர்டன் ரூல்ஸ். த ஃபஸ்ட் அண்ட் ஃபோர்மோஸ்ட் ரூல் இஸ் வி ஹாவ் டு அவாய்ட் லூஸ் கிளாத்திங். அண்ட் செகண்ட், வி ஹாவ் டு வியர் ஷூஸ். And tools should always be kept in good working condition. They have to be placed in the proper place. And while chiseling, or if you are going to use any other sharp tools, the sharp edges should be positioned away from your body. And finally, if you find any boards containing nail, it should be disposed in a proper place. It should not be kept in floor. So these are all some of the rules to be followed in carpentry shop. Now let's see the tools which should be used in carpentry. So first is a steel rule. We all know that the steel rule is used for measuring. So it is a measuring tool. So here you can see the side is around 30 mm. One side is 30 mm and the other side is 40 mm. This workpiece, the sides are 30 and 40 mm. And second is a tri-square. This tri-square is used for marking and checking right angles. So you can see he is just checking whether the workpiece is at right angle. The sides are at right angle. And the next is marking gauge. So this marking gauge is used for marking. You can see marking pins in this particular video. You can see marking pins, which are all small nails. So this is used for marking, or it is used for making parallel lines. So initially you have to set the value, maybe 10 centimeter or 15 centimeter or 10 mm, 15 mm. So we are marking as 10 mm, and it is fixed. Once it is fixed, you can draw a line. Without the use of pencil, we can have marking over the wooden piece by this marking gauge. So now you can see a small marking over the workpiece. So this is how the marking gauge can be used. Without the use of pencil and scale, you can use marking gauge. And next is saw. We all know that saw is used for cutting. And this saw is rip saw. We have two types of saws. One is rip saw and second one is tenon saw. So this is rip saw. It is used for cutting some huge work pieces. It is placed, and this is known as tenon or back saw. So this is used for fine and accurate work. So if you are going for a very smooth finish, then you can use tenon saw. So before using rip saw or tenon saw, initially you have to mark where you are going to cut. So for that we are using tri-square. Here you can see the clean line which is being drawn over the wooden piece. And when you are using pencil, make sure your pencil is sharp. And don't add too much pressure over the pencil, because the tip may break. This is carpenter bench vise, which is used for holding the workpiece. The workpiece should be firmly clamped so that there is no movement on the workpiece. And this is how you have to hold the rip saw. Since he is a trained person, he is just putting his hand nearby the rip saw, but you are not supposed to do it. You have to add a little pressure while cutting. Next is chisel. So these are all again some of the cutting tools used for shaping and fitting wooden pieces. So it consists of steel blade and wooden handle. This steel blade is having two faces. At one face it is very flat, and the other face it is somewhat tapered. This tapered position, or this tapered side, should face over the workpiece where you are going to remove. and the flat surface should face over the workpiece where you are going to keep it. So the removal portion should be facing over the tapered surface. And next is planing tools. These are all some of the planing tools. They are known as metal jack planes, and it is used for creating some smooth surfaces. So if you are having any uneven surface over the workpiece, for smoothening or creating a flat surface, you can use metal jack plane. So before using metal jack plane, you have to again firmly clamp the workpiece. So this jack plane helps to create a very smooth surface over the workpiece. And now you can see the smooth surface. And this tapered side should face the workpiece where you are going to remove. And this is known as mallet, and it is used for striking. It is a striking tool. So you can see the tapered side of the chisel is facing the place where the workpiece, the part of the workpiece is removed. And the flat side is facing the workpiece where we are going to hold it. I hope you have got some information related to the carpentry tools and some best practices to be followed in carpentry shop. I'll meet you in the next video with a new content. Thank you for watching.